Today is really the first full investigative day on scene. We were able to board the vessel. I boarded the vessel around noon along with our marine safety team and our highway safety team. So we were able to confirm that there were 21 crew members on board the vessel at the time of this accident, plus two pilots. We did bring in one of NTSB's senior hazmat investigators today to begin to look at the cargo and the cargo manifest. He was able to identify 56 containers of hazardous materials. That's 764 tons of hazardous materials, mostly corrosives, flammables, and some miscellaneous hazardous materials, class 9 hazardous materials, which would include lithium-ion batteries.
Information from the Dolly's voyage data recorder, or what we call a VDR, was successfully recovered on the morning of the accident by the U.S. Coast Guard. At 0124 and 59 seconds, numerous audible alarms were recorded on the ship's audio bridge audio. About the same time, VDR sensor data ceased recording. However, the VDR audio continued to record using the redundant power source. At around 0126 and 2 seconds, the VDR resumed recording sensor data, and during this time, there were steering commands and rudder orders recorded on the audio.
This bridge was in satisfactory condition. The last fracture critical inspection was in May 2023. We have not been able to go through that inspection and all the documents, but that will occur after we leave the on-scene portion. And so I have no doubt that we will be able to pull this together in hopefully 12 to 24 months.